What is up, everyone? Welcome back to Kerbal Space Program with PNCKS. As I said I would last time, I've done a little bit of research. Not much, just a little bit of research. Help us get a better design going here. I did find out a couple very helpful tips, including one from one of the YouTube viewers who mentioned a little comment, which I'll take to heart, and I'll get to that when I actually make use of the tip that he gave us. So let's start off with our standard set here. I'm going to have got a new design in mind for our base pod here. Pretty much just tuning in. We are on the Katrina mission, which is to, where are we at, 13? Katrina mission, which is to get a ship into orbit and then back to Kerbin with a last section still intact to land safely as a lander back on Kerbin. Let's see, do I want, do I need anything else? Oh, yeah, I do need something else in here. I want some RCS fuel and RCS thrusters. Snap to angles, symmetry on. Get that on there. Alright, and then I'm going to take some of these structural pylons. I learned this. This is one of the things that I found out about. These structural pylons, they weigh less than the radial decouplers. They don't have quite as much ejection force. As you can see, there's 30 versus the 120. But we're not actually going to be ejecting these, probably. But we want the capability should we need it. So we're going to use those. I think these little fuel tanks should be enough to get us what we want to do here. Along with some of these boosters. These vectoring boosters here. Let's see. What else do I need to see? Okay, I'm going to lift this up a little bit. And put some of our winglets. I just love the look of these winglets. I don't know how useful they actually are on that last section, but they look really awesome, so I'm gonna throw it on anyway. Let's get a decoupler on here. And then we're going to put advanced SAS module, as always, to help us control this nicely. Keep us nice and stable without too much effort put into keeping things straight up. And then here's what we're going to do. Some design tips I've picked up. Let's get this guy up here a good bit. I'm going to put about 3 fuel tanks here. And that with a vectoring fuel engine there, or liquid fuel engine. Let's put some of these radial decouplers. We're going to go with a 6 symmetry this time. Get us a lot more engines on here. We're going to repeat the number of stacks of fuel tanks there. Get us a lot more fuel, a lot more firepower. If I can get them to attach properly. And then we'll put some of these much more powerful liquid fuel engines, but don't have the thrust vectoring, so they're harder to control down at the bottom. I think, again, I love these winglets. I'm gonna put these down here because they look so cool, and they also should help SAS to keep us level. And then, so here is one of the things I learned and part of the tip that was given to us by a YouTube user. We're going to run some fuel from the bottom of these tanks to the top of the central tank here. Let's actually do this on the top here as well. Ooh, that's not what I want. I need to click the fuel again. Go back on there. Alright, so from here to here. What that'll allow us to do is to, if we move this engine, this middle engine, down here so that it fires along with the 6 engines around the outside, the fuel lines here will allow this engine to eat up the fuel from these side fuel tanks before it starts resorting to the middle tanks. And if you run it from the bottom to the top, these lines are directional, so that it will only allow the middle one to steal fuel from the side ones and not the other way around. So we can then drain these faster with more power, then ditch them faster, and still leave all the rest of the middle fuel for the middle engine to use alone. Same goes for this. We probably, again, won't resort to that, but that's sort of something we will use once we eventually get a design we want to take to the moon. What I'm thinking we'll want is like a lander like this section I have here that we're going to land back on Kerbin, and then a middle section that can kind of just blast off, leave these three engines as kind of mementos back on the moon, and then hopefully we have enough fuel to just get us in position to crash course back into Kerbin, pretty much. That's the hope. So let's make sure that all of our stages are in order here. I also want to move this one down here, I think. And see, I think as soon as we... No, that's not true. Okay, we'll ditch this. We can ditch these six, which will leave this engine still firing. And put us into this stage, which then once we start that up, it will... see, I think, yeah, we need to move this down. We can drop off that middle section and start up these remaining four engines same time. And we can drop off those three side engines, leaving the middle one firing, and our very last stage would be to deploy the parachute should we need be. And actually, now that I think about it, deploying the parachute probably not going to do us a lot of good. Unless I got some more parachutes on here. This is entirely too much weight for the parachute to save us. We could add another decoupler. Let's do that. Let's have a, that's not what I need to do. We'll have a emergency, because I have no idea if this design's gonna work. I'm hoping it takes a lot, steals a lot from other designs that I looked up, but if it all fails, we can decouple all the way down to just having a parachute and a pod, and that'll, so long as we're in atmosphere, we'll save those Kerbals. All right, there's Katrina 13. So let's take this guy for a fly. Alright. Nothing broke right off the bat, which is always a good sign. Let's throttle up. I think everything looks good here. Does it? Why is this? That's not right. Some decouple right off the bat? That's not what we want our first stage to be. Let's take this back. Hold on a second. That's not where I meant to go anyway. What is this? What is this madness? Yeah, that's those. I don't want those to come off right away. What is this then? Oh geez, this is all out of order. I don't want you to go off until up here. In fact, I don't want you to go off until... What is it? Oh, it's only three of them. Okay. Engine's firing here. I want this. Let's add an additional stage here. It's kind of some weird reordering that I haven't really had to do yet, but I think we want to decouple off these, those guys there, which will leave those, leave that middle engine firing, but get rid of those six side tanks and side engines. Middle engine still firing. We'll press space again. Would get the other engines firing. We don't want to. Yeah, we want to decouple off that middle section. We don't want to decouple off those engines yet. We want to save that for another stage here. And then finally, if we absolutely need to, we can get rid of that last section. I think that's right. Okay, my bad. Good thing we spotted that. Clear the path. Let's get this started. That was going to be a total disaster. Feeling smarter about the game. Feel good. Feel nice. Alright. Billy Bobrim, Shepri, and Johnry. We've dealt with Billy Bobrin before. He's a maniac, so you know, always a good thing to have the one crazy guy on board to keep the mission going, even in its worst of times. All right, I think the throttle's up here. I think we're ready to go. Let's give it a short countdown: 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and blast off! All right, we're off the ground. Oh shit! I didn't turn on SAS. Had a little bit of an angle there. More height this time. I mean, we're already at 2,000 meters, 2 kilometers, not even through our first fuel tanks. We've gone down a little bit, don't overheat. It's going to speed us up, I think. Kind of a weird tilt going. Oh, I realized I didn't strut anything. Oh, jeez. Let's hope that doesn't come back to bite us in the ass. Going really well, I think. Where are we at on the map here? Apoapsis, 15 kilometers. I'm gonna keep this slightly off the middle degree just so I don't accidentally mess anything up. 20 kilometers on our last fuel tanks on the side there. This guy get up a little bit more. Oh geez, what happened here? Oh, struts. Throttle down. Oh man, these guys have got to be getting. Oh no. All right. So lesson learned from. Let's just click through those last two stages there that do us no good. Why can't we throttle up? What's going on? Get rid of that fourth stage. There we go. Alright, so SAS turn off. Turn off. Let's get RCS and SAS both on here and try and counteract this rotation. Man, we got sent through a whirlwind here. Come on. Can we just do it with just RCS? All right, slow down a little bit here. There we go. SAS lock us in a little bit. It's not doing too hot, it's locking us in here. Out a little bit. I have no idea where we're at height wise. Alright, we're starting to fall back. No. Alright. So our lack of struts here has pretty much fucked us. I'm gonna go ahead and just cancel this whole thing. Let's see if we can't rotate ourselves out of here. Get that. Oh jeez, did I just fuck us? No, alright, I'm good. Luckily the SAS force of the pod itself is enough to kind of ditch everything else away from us. Alright guys, you'll all live to see another day because I was smart enough to get us just a pod and a parachute so you guys could live. Let's go ahead and end that flight early. And fix our major flaw here. Struts, people. Don't forget your struts. Vastly important. That did not work. I don't know. Ooh, bad. Why? Oh, of course. Drinking game, guys. I forget to put on the symmetry again. Okay. So I'm hoping if I strut these to the middle, I don't really want to strut them all themselves because I want it to break off. Although I guess that may not work either. Do those... Can I break those? If I move those up here... What are these? Those are our fuel lines. If I move those up here, can I break them off? I'm hoping those break off. I guess I'll go ahead and do them to each other as well. Just to keep everything tidy. I hope those break off and it doesn't just like fall as one whole section, because that might cause some problems, but... Alright, and then that leaves these guys, which... with those winglets, probably gonna be an issue. So we might have to ditch those and just go back to just that. Or, here's an idea. I can put those winglets on here. Yeah, still looks good. Still looks nice. Alright, Mark II. Not enough for major revision. Fix the issues. Hopefully this means we can keep it straight. I'll turn off... Oh, damn it. All those struts down there. Typically the automatic assigning of where these stages should be is right on target, but not so. Not so today. I think, yeah, that's where we want it. We want them to break when we break those. So where's that? Is that last one up there? Six of those? Why is there six? Maybe it's the counts the points? No, that's not the right ones. Oh, jeez. Those need to go down here. Where are these struts? Down there. I don't want those down there. That's 15. I just want these. Let's get rid of these. Turn around symmetry again. And put those back on. Can I, like, click a stage? Where am I? Okay. I want them to go to 2. Just want them to go to 2. Click. Click. Where are they? Put them down at the bottom. No. Put them in with those 15, because that would be god-awful. Ah. What a pain in my ass. Alright, so there's one. Oh, this is gonna suck. Okay. Hopefully it's these three bottom ones at least. I think that's the case. Alright, so that wasn't as difficult as I thought it was gonna be. So now those three up here, but I actually want them one more stage up. Perfect. So now those will blast, one those will blast. Perfect. Okay, that's what we want. Jeez, I've never had more issues with the stage layout than I have today. Alright, throttle up, wait for our frame rate to catch up, and 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and blast off. You see me get RCS and SAS locked in right in the right time. Maybe we can turn off RCS though, save that fuel. Speed this up, things are looking good. Crack my neck, hopefully too loud on the mic. I doubt it, as these rockets are loud as hell. Oh jeez, what's going on? No! Stop it, stop it, stop it! Oh! Oh. Why? Jesus Christ. Get out of here. Alright. What the hell's going on with this design? Does all our crud fall into the ground? Something is making my weight terribly unequal. What could it be? What could it be? Man, I don't know. Maybe it's my winglet obsession. maybe it's these fuel lines, although they should only add a minuscule amount of weight. I don't... just don't know. And they should be equal all the way around, no matter what. These top ones? No, we don't really need those for this go-round. Also, those aren't even attached right. Look at what an idiot I am. They're attached from the bottom of each side one to the side one next to it. That's not even close to right. I mean, I guess it's kind of close. But not very close at all. Where? I can't even click them. And I can't, like, zoom in anymore. I don't know, man. Let's just get rid of them this way. Can I do this? Where is the fuel line? Fuel line, fuel line, fuel line, fuel line. Fuel line, fuel line. Delete. Delete. I didn't do shit. I can't just delete them from here. Nope, not. Oh god. No. Delete. Ugh, damn. I do have to try and click these guys.
When you take an incarnation,
this is being a pain.
It's like getting into a spacesuit.
Ass. Alright. There we go. Ooh, I got it. Okay.
And the whole program for running that spacesuit on this plane of existence.
So let's do this. Here. Two. Definitely here.
That whole mechanism is something that
okay.
is like software in the system, and it has to be developed.
Here to here.
You develop
did I click
software,
the
and that happens
I
through
did not.
Your DNA code, through your socialization process, through
that's the top thing.
You meet and talk to.
And of course, when I do finally get it right, I do not have symmetry on.
An interesting thing that your
awesome.
Whole sense of separateness is really.
That's what we're looking for.
Rooted
I still have no idea if that's our balance problem. I have advanced sass. I believe adding more sass stuff helps. I don't know if I want to add that much weight. Maybe we just don't have enough sass controllers for how much stuff we have on here. But I don't want to add 6. I may want to add 3. Alright, let's turn off symmetry altogether. See if I can do every other one of these tanks. Right there.
And so I somehow experienced
myself. Right there. How about that? Let's see, maybe possibly that does what we want to do. Still, you know, symmetrical weight wise.
Separateness and having not the power to control that.
Let's pray. Okay.
But I couldn't get what
this
I wanted,
is gonna be Mark. Not Mark 4. Skip a whole revision. Mark 3.
And I only became the somebody who wanted something because I couldn't, because I didn't have what I wanted all the time.
There is no reason why these should be in their own stage. I have no idea what that would even do.
I had to learn once, by the way.
How about we move you up here?
I wanna.
Alright. Everything else should be still the same as it was, so I hopefully don't need to mess with it too much. And let's go ahead and try this guy again. This is so strange, like this is failure that I can't even really comprehend why. I like the failure that's totally me screwing up or my design being terrible, but this everything looks good and I'm still screwing up here. Alright, RCS, SAS. Throttle up. 5 more things in 1. And bust up. RCS on the whole time. I'm maybe wasting the RCS fuel, but I hope I won't need it. And I'd rather it help me get out of atmosphere than to totally fail this whole mission because my ship decides to randomly turn about. Right, where's our fuel at? We are on our third tanks already? Maybe? possibly. I'm not positive, actually. Where are we at? Where's our apoapsis? 15 kilometers. No, that was... Alright, this is our last set of tanks. I do believe... 6 tanks. 7 engines. Looking good. Alright, so I'm gonna speed this back down to 1 here. Because I believe our apoapsis is, yeah, exactly what we wanted. Let's throttle these down. All the way, even, because, you know, we'll throttle up a little bit more. Very low throttle.
Into what?
Speed that up until we reach. Yeah, that's good. Oh, oh. Alright, let's turn off SAS, turn off RCS, and get our rotation here. Lock it in. Oh, actually, we're way further than I thought we were. We can totally just go straight 90 from here.
Still here.
Lock that in. Turn it over a little bit, actually. There we go. Lock that in. Throttle back up. Oh, we lost those tanks. Ooh, yeah, that split perfectly. Fantastic. And we will eat through some of this fuel, getting ourselves into an orbit.
I look back at all the years.
Is that moving at all?
Taking it all so seriously.
It's moving. Not moving at a rate I'd like. And we're eating through fuel like nothing else.
I have any clues,
so let's
any
take advantage of some gravity help here, maybe.
I was caught in some weird psychosis, group psychosis.
We lost one tank already. Are we even making it into orbit? Why am I not going as fast as I think I would be? Well, I guess that's the slower engine. Oh shit, and I'm overheating it a little bit. I went way higher than I needed to, which is gonna be a waste of fuel. Because I'm a silly, silly goose. And not very good at this game. But I'm learning, guys. I'm learning. I would like to... come on. This is not going well. This is gonna, I'm doubling my effort here by going twice as high as I need to. Let's throttle this down. I don't know. I have no idea what I'm doing. Let's not joke. I'm just bad. We're falling rapidly. I don't. Whatever. You know. Let's. Whatever. Let's get this up to slightly higher. I'm still falling. God damn it. Go. Gain height. Don't lose height. Oh jeez. Oh god. Slow you down. Let's just try and land this guy. Oh, this is actually incredibly difficult to control. Oh my goodness. Nope. So, PS guys, don't go with this design here. Get out of here. Come on. Yeah, alright. I'm not sure where I'm at time-wise, but I'm gonna go ahead and say let's stop the video here. I'm gonna keep playing, and I will make this another video that'll go up pretty quickly after the other one, but just to It's a matter of size considerations. I'm going to go ahead and stop the video here. So I will see you guys next time. Thank you very much for watching.